When I was a kid back in the 1970s, the $6 million man was a pop culture icon of human enhancement. He was an astronaut rebuilt with bionic implants after a tragic accident, giving him super strength, speed, and vision. 50 years later, we are still obsessed with the idea of superhuman transformation. Hollywood pumping out blockbusters like X-Men, Captain America, and Dune, showing us worlds where humans are engineered with special abilities to fight bad guys and save the universe. The idea of human enhancement is nothing new, from prosthetics found on ancient Egyptian mummies, yes, that's true, to wheelchairs in 6th century China, also true, to Viking warriors who ate toxic plants to feel more fearless in battle. But the mechanical and digital revolutions of the 20th century increased the scope dramatically of what we thought was possible, leading to the birth of transhumanism, a philosophical movement that believes humans are in the early phase of evolution and need technology, and it's coming fast, to transcend our physical and cognitive limitations. Here is transhuman philosopher FM2030, that's his name, on Larry King back in 1989.
If you're around in 2030, there's an excellent chance you can coast to immortality, indefinite lifespans. Mind you, Larry, not with these bodies and certainly not on this planet only.
Jesus, we just missed.
No, we haven't.
Sadly, Larry King didn't make it to 2030, but you and I may, fingers crossed. And while we haven't figured out the whole immortality thing yet, advances in gene editing, synthetic biology, and neural implants mean that the transhuman future is a lot closer to reality. 5 years ago, a rogue doctor in China stunned the medical world when he announced he created genetically modified babies designed to resist HIV. In 2021, Elon Musk's brain implant company, Neuralink, posted a viral video of a monkey playing Pong with only its mind.
Pages still moves the joystick out of habit, but as you can see, it's unplugged. He's controlling the cursor entirely with decoded neural activity.
And in 2023, they got FDA approval for human trials. Then, this past October, experts announced a genetic therapy to treat sickle cell anemia was safe for clinical use, and that set the stage for the first ever FDA-approved CRISPR treatment, a technology that uses RNA and proteins to selectively edit DNA. All these developments hint at a future of disease eradication, independence from physical disability, and recovery from traumatic brain injury, but with the good comes lots and lots of risk. Gene editing raises the specter of designer babies, eugenics, and the slippery slope to creating a genetic underclass. There's also the not at all terrifying possibility of militaries using biotech to create super soldiers who need less sleep, have more muscle mass. Then there's the question of privacy as tech firms gain unprecedented access to our data, our biometric data, and our medical histories. We don't want that. Not to mention bad actors. I mean, if your brain is partially powered by a computer, what happens when somebody hacks it? We need to strike a balance between embracing biotech's life-changing potential and safeguarding our values, our ethics, and the idea of what it means to be a human being. These tools are going to lead to profound advances in human life, and we'll experience them. But how do we make sure that the enhanced humans of the future end up being superheroes and not supervillains?